Hi everybody, my name is Rick, and today I like to show how to play Ain't She Sweet on a banjo-ukulele. What is the special thing about a banjo-ukulele? It is as loud as a ukulele can get. There is no louder ukulele. I like to start with some typical right-hand techniques for the banjo-ukulele. We will start with a finger-picking style, and it's a simple one. We just use our thumb and our index finger, and we take thumb, index finger, and we take the fourth string, then the second one, then the third one, and the first one. So this is string 1, 2, 3, 4. And our right hand rests on the skin of the banjo-ukulele with the middle finger, or with the middle and the ring finger. And then you go number 4, number 2, number 3, number 1. 4 with the thumb, 2 with the index finger, 3 with the thumb, and 1 with the index finger. We do that 2 chords, and then we do a regular strumming. Second thing I like to show is a strumming pattern with the right hand. You just open your right hand, but you open it finger by finger, like this. And then you try to strum all 4 strings with each finger. This gives a very loud strum, because you actually have like 4 strums in one. And we use that to set an accent on the first beat of a measure, like this. And now I like to show a strumming pattern, which is also based on that 4-finger strum. So you start that strum, and then after that down stroke with the 4 fingers, your thumb is on top of the fingerboard, and you do a down stroke with your thumb. At the same time, you move your index finger up, that the index finger is at the bottom of the fretboard, and then you do up strum with your index finger. So the 4-finger stroke, the thumb down stroke, and the index finger up stroke. And again, we do that 2 chords, and then we do a standard strumming like this. And altogether, it sounds like this. few minutes left, and therefore I like to explain why most of the Banjo-Ukuleles don't sound very well. There are two main problems. One problem is that the bridge position is wrong for most ukuleles, and this is because the bridge is just pressed down by the strings. It's not glued on the skin or anything, so it's movable. And sometimes if you hit it or whatever, then the position moves and then your intonation is not okay. And first thing you should do if your Banjo-Ukulele sounds somehow out of tune, check the position of the bridge. And this is what you have to do. You compare the open string with the same string in the 12th fret, and this should be one octave higher. You can check that with a chromatic tuning device. And if the note up here is too sharp, then the bridge goes a little bit back, and if it's too flat, the bridge goes a little bit to the front. And then you check it on the first and the fourth string and move and twist the bridge so that all the four strings are in tune. That means the open string is the same note like the same string played in a 12th fret. And the second thing is that after a while the tension of the skin goes down and you have to tighten the screws. And you can, if you go around here and touch it, the sound should be similar. If the sound is too high, then the tension is higher, and if the sound is low, then the tension is not high enough, and you have to change the screws. What you can do is you open the screws and then just hand tight them, and then take your key and tighten them about half a turn, which is for most of the Banjo-Ukuleles quite good. And then you tighten always crosswise, this one and then this one, and then from here to here. Try not to go around like this, screw to screw, but always to the opposite side. That is all I wanted to say about Ain't She Sweet on a Banjo-Ukulele. Thank you for watching.